Aleluya. Proverbia I need to learn. How to live with God in the world. Because there are so many things that can take you away from God's presence. There are so many things that are able to convince you or to confuse you. There are so many things that can drive you left and right. There are so many things that can take away your attention over time. There are so many things that can even steal away your attention and your wisdom and your prayer. But this morning, let's talk and know how it is happening. How does it happen? And how we can overcome it?
No, conca ulipi ato drugu sufinda.
Listen here. In this world,
takutwa kumi muno.
There are five signs.
Oh, puno puno maditiri ko eri ata no.
That we can learn from.
Ingo ato drugu ilongera mo.
We can learn from the things of this world.
Ato drugu ilonga ko, ato ilongera ko ko ini mamo kumi muno.
Sometimes we might learn and get your things in the right way. Sometimes you can learn and forget the words of God. Sometimes they can confuse you. But as long as you are in the flesh, you need to know them and you need to overcome them and you need to control them and you need to overcome them. So number one, we are talking about seeing. You see things. Sometimes you desire them. Sometimes we see things. And sometimes they can read you to see. But remember that we need to see. So it's not a thing for us to see. And it does not mean that when you see everything is good for you. And it does not mean that you need to see everything that people are seeing. But you have eyes. When you have a mouth, it does not mean that you can eat everything. You have to control your eating, but you have a mouth. You might find people are eating snake, but also you have a mouth. Can you eat a snake? You can find some of my tribe that are here, they like to eat donkey. But you cannot eat a donkey. If they find you eating a fish and there is a donkey that is dead in there, they say, hey, you are wasting your time. That's not food. Don't tell you that if you see a meat of donkey, you should eat it. That's why you eat. Otherwise, if you come back, you will find nothing. Some of the tribes, they eat cats. But you don't even love to see a cat. So we need to understand these things. Number two. Hearing. Hearing. You will hear everything because you have ears. But it does not mean that everything is good for you. It does not mean that everything you hear that you benefit. Sometimes you hear things and they will lead you to sin. Sometimes you hear things and you discourage you. They can destroy your faith. They can destroy your connection between you and Jesus Christ. Because I don't know if you know that everything that you are paying attention to, listen, you take something. But you are not aware sometimes. That's why some of you, if you watch scary movies and you are listening, from there you are not going to sleep. One day I was listening to one testimony. And the man said, I like to watch the horror movies. So for you, you can read the story. And you read. But after you read,
you
need a bottle of a drink or something. Food or chocolate or sweets. Even though you read it, you still want to taste. So that you believe. Some people, they don't just spend and they spend and they spend and they
do.
They need also to test. They want to test. So that they will believe that what you people you write here, I know you are the one who manufacture this, but what you write on top here, this is inside. They speaking the truth when they write here. Oh yes, this one I love it. Oh, this is my favorite. It's the best even the one that I buy when I went to Angola. And they have one name, but this one I love.
Oh, in a dinner, you may ask if no one is your name.
Number four. Is it number four?
Yes.
Eh? Smell.
Is it in there? Can you hold the Majimba?
Eh? Smell.
Get Jimba.
So someone can tell me that this place is not good. Just can you feel the smell?
Oh, put on the program. But I would never know. I say, wow, the Majimba.
They say, I love this guy, he dress nice, but can you imagine the smell? Sometimes you pass by, you find lady standing, you pass by. When you pass by, the moment you go a bit far, you see them doing like this. Hey, I love the perfume. But when you are coming from them, they can't buy it. But the moment you pass by, this man that you live with them, provoke them. And the smell of this place that this guy wear. I love the perfume of this man that he wear. And they will keep looking at you. You check the way it is. You smell what I love. Someone will come in the certain place. Ah, maybe there's something dead here. Let's start searching. There must be something wrong here.
The person believe. Number five. What is number five?
Feelings.
O marido.
Feelings.
O marido.
I feel like sleeping.
Como que tenha quando ela vou cofar?
Yes, I love to go to church, but I feel like sleeping.
Quando ela queria comer, ela acha que quando ela não tem nada vou cofar.
But what does the word of God says?
Acho que ainda vai ter que mudar também.
Does the word of God told you that when you feel like sleeping, you should not go to church? Does the word of God told you that teach you that when you feel what you feel, you should not obey the word of God? I want you to tell me somebody now in your heart. Do you come to church for how you feel? Or you come to church because you want to honor God is calling? Or you are coming to church because you want to answer God is calling? Then if it's about God's invitation, there's nothing to do with your feelings. It has nothing to do with what you feel. It has nothing to do with what you see. It has nothing to do with what you want. There is a problem. So when we are following and obeying all these things, this is contradicting with the scripture that we are reading now. Because these scriptures, they are talking about obeying the word of God. Living in the spirit is when you are obeying the word of God. It has nothing to do for what you have seen when you were born in 1930. It has nothing to do with what you heard that if you read the Bible, you will become a mental problem. It has nothing to do with what you learn at school in philosophy. The Bible is greater than the philosophy that will talk to you about philosophy. The Bible had been already from the beginning when it was in the flesh, before even you were born. I don't know if you understand the secret. That when Jesus Christ comes, that is the word of God. When the Bible says in the book of Faith, when the Bible says the book of John chapter 1, from verse 1 and up to 5, that the word was become flesh. The word was God and God was with God. Listen, when Jesus Christ came in the flesh, he came with the Bible inside you. That's why the Bible says in the word of God, the Bible becomes flesh. So the Bible is referring to Jesus Christ when he comes. When he comes, he was a pure word of God. So some people are learning when they look at his action. Some people were learning when they are listening to him. His word, his action, his life,
Hallelujah.
And this is what you're supposed to follow. This is what you're supposed to keep in you. So that you become the word of God. So that you live in the word of God. So that your life will be transformed in the word of God. So that you become the word of God. This is how you're supposed to live. But today, because of lack of knowledge, we are no longer living the life Jesus Christ expects us to live. We are disappointing Jesus Christ every day. This morning I come to you as a word in the flesh, so that I will awake your mind. Not a worry.